I'm sitting here in Pigeon Forge, which is where Dollywood is, waiting at this bank for my account to clear. And I'm obsessing about this song. It's The Police. Now this song is called Synchronicity 2. And it describes a family setting in the suburbs where the grandmother's shouting and there's this din and the father can't take it anymore. And he has to like go to work every day and he hates it. He doesn't understand why. But he stares off in the distance thinking always that something has to give. And then it goes to a completely different setting, a dark Scottish loch, where there's this slime creature. It's almost like a B-movie. You got the slime creature in every verse, something stirring on the bottom. Now what does this have to do with the suburban story? It's hard to put your finger on that kind of thing. The thing about art is that it's open to your interpretation. And nobody's gonna like lock you up in jail if you arrive at the wrong interpretation. At the most, you're gonna spark a debate. The idea of synchronicity, I imagine, is that things across the world are happening in concert together. Although your experience is isolated, there's something out there that's mirroring what you are. And in this case, the synchronicity is, I think, between the man and the monster. Very bleak understanding of civilization. If you think of it in terms of evolution, you know, we all came from the water, came up, and as far as we can go is to become a shadow on the floor of a cottage. We can't get any higher than that. We're always just going to be primordial. I think that's what the song is saying. I just figured it out. I've been obsessing about this stupid song sitting here. And that's my interpretation. So throw me in jail if you think it's wrong.
And frustration, but we don't all.
Sting doesn't seem to feel he needs to say it because everybody knows what happens next after the monster casts the shadow on the floor. That's when the unspeakable horror happens.